Okay, we're going to do another in the sauna series here. And this time we're going to talk about just the beginning stages on how to really start your first time in the sauna. This is a super good friend of mine, actually a better brother than my brothers at times, Stanley Abrego. And how long have you been working with me and the family?
Almost like 10
years?
Yeah.
Okay, and his father, he's been working with me for 25 years. Can't believe that. 25 years. And so his father runs the whole farm here and does everything. From cutting the lawn to fixing the well, whatever needs to get done, to feeding the animals, taking care of an orchard with 700 lychee trees and 20 varieties of bananas, 20 varieties of avocados, 2,000 or so coffee trees. A lot of work here, right?
Yeah, it is.
So Stanley's helping his dad right now. He lives in Cali. So just to give you a little background here. So today we're gonna show you how to use, because have you ever been in the sauna before?
No, first time.
Okay. So this is perfect. And to be able to show people really how to use the sauna is the best way to be able to get out a lot of garbage that's living underneath your skin. Okay, but you gotta open up the skin pores first. And you can do that a variety of ways. But the sauna, once your skin pores are open, once your body starts to river sweat, you can see Stanley's. We've only been in here 5 minutes, okay? And his body's super healthy because it sweats. And a lot of people that come in here, okay, the big problem is that they don't sweat for 20 minutes. You imagine that?
Not dirty.
Not a drop. Not a drop. They're plugged, okay? So, you know, as you start coming into the sauna, what happens is better time lapse of view, not just sweating, but river sweating, like Stanley's doing right now. His river's got drips dropping off his face. I'd usually be sweating too right now, but my house got stone floors, so it really makes me cold real quick. So my core temperature was a little bit less, but I can feel I just got my first couple of drops now. I'll catch up to Stanley in a couple minutes. So
eventually.
Yep. So, you know, the reason why he sweats, though, just so you know, is because this guy works. Works out in the sun. I see you guys, you and your dad. Your bodies are sweating, okay? All day.
All day long.
That's why your dad's been with me for 25 years. I can't get him to come in the sauna because he says, I sweat all day long. And he does. And if you don't sweat, you're not healthy. That's the way it works. So, because once you sweat, your body starts to release. There's a lot of plastic, okay, that's in everything. This is a plastic spoon I'm using here for the guashing session. I'm going to show you my tools here. But we use plastic on everything, and we drink a lot of water bottles and so forth, and there's stuff called bisphenol A. And bisphenol A goes in our bodies and plugs us up. So you got to be very careful of that. But then again, how do you get all the bisphenol A? And if you look that up, bisphenol A cancer, and or just look and see how bisphenol A has been outlawed in Canada and many European countries. Why? Because it disrupts your hormone system. Okay, they're xenoestrogens. Okay, phytoestrogens are from plants. That's why I don't have any wheat, corn, or soy. Try not to at all. They promote higher levels of estrogen, and that's what these plastics do. So the sauna is the most effective way to get bis A out of your system, as long as you can sweat. If you can't sweat, it's because you're plugged. Okay, he's sweating. Okay, so he's easy to clean up. He's already like been in here 20 times. Okay, why? Is because this is what happens to you after about 15 or 20 times in the sauna. Your body really river sweats, just like it's doing right now. You can see his face, got drops coming off his chin there. Okay, so infrared saunas, let's just go over just a couple of quick things here. We've only been in here 8 minutes, and I can feel right now my body's just catching up. The more body fat you have, remember, just means the more plugged that you are. And if your body does sweat, even though Stanley's gained some weight, got married there, he's got children, he's got food all the time. Mom's probably a good mom at home there, making great food. And, you know, if your body sweats, at least you can get a lot of the poisons out of it, as long as you keep drinking good liquids to dilute yourself. So he's easy to clean up because his body already sweats. So you can easily release tons of garbage through your skin. Remember, it's not just, you know, cleaning up your food intake. Once you do that, then how do you get all the accumulated residue out of your body? That's the big question. So, and we do a lot of these different protocols on Earther Academy, share with you more therapeutic and more advanced ways of detoxification and rejuvenation. That's our private school. Now, what I suggest people do is, you know, I'm not going to say to drink this vodka here, but this is a good solution to drink too. We have a protocol for that on an empty stomach for intestinal cleansing. But this is to clean your skin, so it's really good to look up how we make the vodka. You can see vodka's clear, but you can see how it's really white. It's got a lot of stuff in there. This is full of minerals, and it's got different things in there to also help neutrify the skin. So, because regular vodka, it's super dry, and it'll just dry you out, make your skin look terrible. So learn how to go ahead and clean your body with the alcohol. You scrub your body from head to toe, if you can, before the sauna. I did mine this morning. I'll show Stanley how to do this. You ever clean your body?
Mm-mm.
Okay.
Do it with salt.
With salt. And that's another smart way. The vodka, what it does is it sanitizes your pores, so goes in and whatever lives in your pores, so does salt too, because it burns a lot of things that live inside your body. But the vodka with the minerals, it's magical to get rid of like bugs and fungus and just taking the grease and garbage, not only off your skin, but in your pores. And then when you get finished with that, you, of course, put coconut oil on and minerals, because if not, the alcohol's dried you out. Now, what do you eat normally, Stanley?
Rice, I think.
You have eggs, you have milk. Salt.
No milk. Okay. No. Not that much dairy, so.
Okay, and then you eat different types of meats?
Yeah, that's for sure.
Okay. And how much water do you think you drink a day?
Probably like a half a gallon, I think.
Uh-huh. Did you hear what he said? Okay. Now, how much soda do you think you drink a day?
Maybe once.
Okay.
Once a day.
Sort of like a treat for you?
Yeah.
Gives you a little boost too.
Yeah, so, a little boost to get going.
Do you have coffee in the morning or tea?
I'm trying that.
Better off having the tea or the coffee in the morning than the soda. And if you want to have more oomph, drink the yerba mate. That's the best tea I found out, because it detoxifies you too. So the reason I'm asking Stanley this is, you know, everybody, how old are you now, Stanley?
33 years old.
Okay. I've known you since when?
You're about 17?
17 years old. He's like my younger brother, okay? And, you know, if you've got good secrets to share, people, so they, in time, can go ahead and actually really stay healthy, because this guy's like his dad. These guys are workers, okay? Their bodies basically can stay cleaner by actually working outside and sweating versus sitting inside in an office job, sitting in a chair all day. Yeah. So, you know, the big picture, though, is, as you get older, you start to realize more that you really got to start taking care of what you put in your body more.
Yeah, that's true.
Because when we're younger, we don't know. If it tastes good, I'll take some more.
That's the way it is. So, you want to come back.
Yeah, exactly. So how many times a day do you eat, though? How many meals?
Right now, like two.
Two? Okay.
One in the morning and one in the afternoon.
Okay, now that's pretty smart too. Remember, I used to eat 7 meals a day because I thought it was supposed to be good for me, being a bodybuilder, to have 7 small meals a day.
Mm-hmm. Like a doctor said.
Yeah, and then when I was younger, I used to have 3 big breakfast, morning, you know, of time, and at lunchtime, dinner, and maybe a dessert before I even went to bed, and snacks along the way, and sodas in between.
Yeah, and you get adjusted to it, your body, that way.
Get adjusted to feeling full all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Because if I eat 1 meal a day, remember, and it's taken me a while to tune down to that 1 meal a day. So I started out with, like Stanley's doing, it's got 2 meals a day gone. So if you're really doing the work you're doing, think about adding another 2 pounds of food in your stomach and going out to work. You eat 2 meals because you're not hungry, or do you eat 2 meals because you think it's better for you?
Better for me.
Okay, which is good. Are you hungry in between?
No, not at all.
Okay. So 2 meals is easy, is what I'm trying to say, okay? You're doing it for 2 things. One, because it's better for you. And number 2 is you know, cutting down on calories, but you know, you're really doing it because that's a good way to be able to, 80% of your body's energy when you eat a big meal goes towards breaking down that food. So you can imagine a big meal and you go out to work, you feel tired, you want to go take a nap. So
yeah, it's nothing you can, it's not really good.
It's not good.
So, you feel lazy.
You feel lazy. Exactly. That's what happens to me. So my one meal a day, I'm hopping all day long. If I'm hungry, I'll have some chocolate. Chocolate feeds my brain. And I'll drink a variety of different liquids. This is a blue-green algae liquid. You can see how it's blue-purpley color. It's beautiful, huh? Look at that. And this liquid is made with distilled water, silica, and minerals. And this hydrates me because we're going to lose water in here. You can't sweat forever. So what do you got to do? You got to keep drinking. Remember, this is a beginning session, so let's go through this. As soon as you come into the sauna, okay, you want to bring a bottle at least this big. Stanley's got his on the ground there. Go ahead and take a few sips there because you want to keep on, because you're sweating and that means you lost all that water. You want to keep replenishing your body with water because once you stop sweating, that's not healthy. Remember, you're in here to sweat, and you'll find out if you don't drink enough water, you stop sweating. So before I even get in here, I try to drink this much too. Okay, I want more water in my body because I want my radiator to let go. Okay, this is, remember, one of the easiest ways to detox yourself is using the sauna correctly. And then...
yeah, mine has a chlorella powder.
So. Oh, there you go, see? And then once you, you know, learn the deeper protocols in the sauna, and then you can really regenerate your tissues of your skin, wrinkles, scars even, stretch marks. You can change the thickness of the body fat. That's really hard. You can break it down and break it down and make it thinner and thinner until your body becomes pretty see-through, the skin, transparent. And it's very, like this guy here is easy because number one, he's young, he's healthy, okay, and he sweats. So these protocols to him are very simple because the hardest thing for anybody to do is when they go in the sauna, if you don't sweat, you got to get out because you feel like you're going to faint.
Yeah. you don't overheat. Feel cooled down at all. Yeah, so.
You overheat.
Yep.
So, okay, so real quick here, let's just go over a couple things. Now, we're in here, it's 147 degrees, okay, you can see right there, and I set the temperature at 147, that's where it's at, but we set the time at 100, and on right now you can see it's, what, 85?
85.
Okay, so we've been here 15 minutes, so it's doing a countdown on us, so we know exactly how long we're in here. Okay, this is a big crystal that we have in here. I like to have crystals and different types of objects that actually add to the energy in here, because this part of this is detoxification. Always bring your liquids in with you. And then here's some of the tools that I bring in all the time when I go into the sauna. And remember, this is more advanced. Stanley's never done this before, so what we're doing is not just going in the sauna, we're going to do some techniques on Stanley, and we're going to see if we can pull some gunk out of his pores that are opening right now, because the gunk won't come out until your pores are open. We have all these products on Earth Shift, even the custom-made guashing blades, different types of instruments to open up your tissues, okay, scrubbing pads. Coconut oil, you want organic, because remember, everything, if you can, you want to get organic, because a lot of chemicals and lots of other things. You're trying to get out the garbage out of your system. Coconut oil, magnesium. This is the pure magnesium here. It's 31% strong. Same with this. This is very strong fulvic that we get specially made. Okay, it's got also boron in it for regeneration. And also boron works very well for regeneration of the skin, okay, but also the pores, shrinking the skin. And we're mostly deficient in boron, so we added it to this. This is a low pH. This is a pH of about 2.2. We also have some iodine because you can use that for different types of protocols we have for taking wrinkles out and stuff. And these are the variety of different types of tools. And you can see we've got the Earthshift symbol in here on the side of this. These are custom made for us. And also essential oils. Very important to go ahead and actually put on your body while you're in here. Just because the essential oils really are pharmacological, medicinal, and nutritional. Depending on which ones you use, I like to use peppermint in here. It makes the air feel cooler, okay? It makes you feel more uplifting. So essential oils, depending on how you use them, they're really, really smart, okay? Then you can also use clove. Clove's really good to use in the sauna. Make sure that you get steam distilled, though, essential oils. And you want to bring a towel. You don't sit on the You can see we're in here right now, and we're sitting on a towel. And we got a towel by our feet, the same thing here. So these are the simple, you know, reason being, want to sweat into the wood. And then after we get done, I spray hydrogen peroxide with some essential oils on the wood. But you don't want to get, you know, all the water. We're going to sweat maybe 3, 4, 5 pounds of water. I want this towel to catch it up. Okay, you'll see when we leave here, I'm going to hold the towel and give it to you and say, hey, look at that. It's a 10-pound towel. And he doesn't smell at all. Okay, a lot of people that come in here, you can smell their toxicity coming out in their system. Okay, right away. It's not something all of a sudden it takes. Once you start sweating, and the people that actually really smell are the ones that don't sweat, is because they're not getting the garbage out of their system.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Yeah. I know you have questions maybe before we do part two. Stanley members never been in the sauna before. You want to, when you first start in the sauna, think of a couple of questions you may want to ask. But when you first start in the sauna, you want to make sure that you don't go ahead and get it too hot. We've got about 145, 147. That's maximum. And I've got the door right here. You can see it's cracked open just a little bit. You can do that. Remember, the positive ions are ions that make us so we can't breathe well. And those are made from these heaters. They're far infrared heaters. So they're hot. You can put your hand on the heater, on a far infrared heater. This is the most effective sauna to get. It's not hot. It's the waves we're feeling that are actually making us hot. They go through our bodies and they heat us up instead of just a hot element that has a huge electrical magnetic field on it. And the air is super toxic. Why? Because you've got way more electricity and way more ions. The good ions, the negative ions, that's why I have the door open, make us so we can go ahead and stay in here a lot longer. So two quick factors on not being able to use the sauna correctly. Your skin, pores, won't sweat. Okay, you didn't drink enough water in here. Not good. Okay, and let's see, what was number three? Making sure you don't have, you know, you got to have ample oxygen in here to be able to feel that, oh, you said you're not getting dizzy because you're sweating and everything else. You got enough water, but you've got only positive ions in here, which make you so you feel nauseated and you have to get out. And if you feel like you have to get out, be careful. So it's way hotter for us in here too, is because we've got these huge lights shining on us right here. And trying to think while you're in here and talk too, let me tell you, that also adds to making you sweat. Okay, what questions do you have at all before we get started?
Just how often you have to go to sauna?
Good question. Now, if you really want to get detoxified, okay, it's really good to do this once a day. And if you just do this without even changing your meals and adding 150 ounces of liquid a day to your meals, in between your meals, okay, and cut yourself down to 2 meals a day, this is without even changing your diet. This will massively unload. Okay, but if you just want to do it, so it's like right now I'm doing this, last time I did it in my sauna was last Sunday. Sunday's my spa day. And this takes out all the accumulation from the week that I had. But if you really want to get garbage out of your system, you can do this up to twice a day as a therapy. You can do this at your house. Remember, you get your own far infrared sauna, and you can do it twice a day. And people that do that, they lose 20 pounds just off the top. Remember, toxicity gives you body fat. Body fat is a live creature and it eats on sugar. So you don't get hungry when you open up your pores, is because the critters inside you don't have the matrix, the acidity, the toxicity that basically gives them power. So just to be able to maintain once a week. But if you really want to clean yourself, you can do it up to twice a day. Give yourself 1 day a week rest, okay? But if you do it every day, I've done this with hundreds of people doing their own experiments, and they said this worked magical, magical. What other question? That was a good question.
Yeah. So, after this, what do you do next? Like,
okay, so
to clean everything, like go and take a shower or something like that?
Okay, again, good question. What do you do after you get out of here? First of all, we're softening up right now. We've been in here now about 22 minutes. That's it. Feels like we've been in here a lot longer though, huh? Thing works you.
Yeah, you can feel the pressure.
You feel this constant radiation of something that's making you sweat. Yeah, that's the far infrared heaters. And there's 7 heaters in this one here. It's a 3-person. 2 people fits really comfortable, but I do trios in the sauna videos all the time. And 3 people do fit in. Just make sure that there's not going to be a smelly one that comes in with you, though. So what do you do after you actually do the protocols in the sauna. If you can, the best thing to do is go to the waterfall. It's cold water and it really tightens up everything. Okay, you go in there and let it give you the best massage you can get, and try to stay in so you actually get a little bit cool and you stay in a little bit longer. Even though the water is probably what down there, 68, maybe 70.
The river water. Less.
Yeah, 65.
Yeah, 65.
Okay. So it's not super cold, but it's cold enough to be able to shock you from 145 right now down to 65. This really, really tightens up your nervous system. And then from there, if you can, take your clothes off and go up anywhere and get full body sun. Full body. Okay. But then again, before you do full body sun, you want to put on coconut oil and magnesium minerals, because this super lubricates your skin and also lets you, so you get about a 15 SPF factor, that's sun blocker factor, from the coconut oil. And you can even put on cacao butter, which is up to 25%. You're just trying to get the UVB rays, and you don't really want the UVAs. And laying out in the sun, and especially getting on areas that don't get sun. When's the last time your private parts had the sun for a half an hour? Think about it.
Yeah.
Man, have you ever done it? Laid out in the sun nude in a long time?
No. I never tried it, but I get, you know, late in the sun. So, but you cannot handle it that much.
But have you ever taken your full body? So your full body. So you got to do it in a private spot, because otherwise it's weird to do. You can't take your clothes off, because otherwise everyone's going to think you're weird.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is what the most healthiest thing to do is, to get sunlight on your testes and on a woman, on all the private parts. Okay, this stimulates your immune system. If you do this for 45 minutes, half an hour even, just open your legs up, you'll feel your whole body down there, because it doesn't get in the sun. And once it gets in the sun, it says, thank you, Stanley. We needed sun. Everything needs sun. It regenerates it, but also it stimulates it with photons. Remember, we eat food for a reason. One reason is to get energy. And so you can get direct energy from the sun as long as your skin will bring in the energy. And one of the best parts to be able to get energy is on your private parts. Okay, this stimulates your hormones, not for sexuality. This is your immune system. Okay, of course it'll stimulate that too, but it stimulates your immune system and it makes you feel stronger.
Stronger,
it makes you
yeah.
feel happier. Okay, you don't have your hormones, you know what happens to you? You don't feel too happy. You feel sort of wimpy, in fact. So, let's see, any other questions? Those are good questions. Okay. And then after that, take a shower. And then put them, you know, I use coconut and magnesium oil on my skin, because this is why my skin's see-through. And the coconut oil's got lauric acid in it, and the magnesium pushes it in. The magnesium is not just magnesium oil, but it's about 80 minerals. And you want to rub this into your skin really good, and it transdermally goes through your skin and feeds your skin. This is beautiful stuff, because you don't have to eat magnesium, because it's in a lot of foods, but in any processed food, it's very rare that it's in there. And if it is, it's just in minimal quantities. But you can put magnesium and the trace minerals right through your skin. And this feeds your cells what it needs. It needs magnesium. They need magnesium to work. So, what else?
Mm-hmm. That's it.
Okay.
Well, for now.
Yeah, for now. Any questions you have, okay, go ahead and ask. So this basic session, again, is if you don't have a far infrared sauna, well, use a dry heat sauna. You usually have them at the gyms, okay? Don't pour any tap water on there, because it's full of chlorine, fluoride, chloramines, whatever else is in the tap water, because it turns into steam and you breathe that stuff in, so you have to really only put distilled water, or put some minerals in the water to aid in, you know, better water. Our steam shower here is super clean water. We have filters that are six-stage filters that clean our rainwater, and then we remineralize it. So you notice I just shut the door a little bit, so how much hotter it got just in 2 seconds. Okay.
2 seconds. That's really smart idea too, you know?
Yep. And so the basics, remember, are just to get you to try it. You got to practice these protocols. All I'm doing here is just showing you some different ideas that will massively change your toxicity level. Okay, remember, the skin is the first thing people see when they see you. First thing. Okay, so a lot of people aren't secure about themselves is because their skin's not good. They got big wrinkles, okay? They've got just a lot of loose skin because they lost maybe 20 or 30 pounds over. They're overweight because they're plugged. They're demineralized. They're dehydrated. They don't work. They sit in a chair all day. They got a lot of bad habits. So, you know, doing this, these protocols is a, don't think of it as sort of like a beauty thing. This is a detox therapy. And once you get garbage out of your system, then you put in, again, better liquids. Make sure you drink a little bit more water again. Better liquids in your system, and I'm urinating through my skin, so you can see how this is very effective. You put water into the river. If you want to clean the lake, you got to clean the rivers up. Quit drinking things that aren't good for you. A lot of sugary products, a lot of sodas, a lot of just processed drinks. And try to get, if you can, remember, esteem distiller, and make your own water like we do here at the retreat here in Hawaii. Steam distiller just makes pure H2O. And then you can add minerals to it, but it's also one of the best detoxing waters. That's what he put in. Did you remember you tried some distilled water before, right?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, and it doesn't make you get diarrhea or anything else, okay?
Mm-hmm. You don't feel nothing at all.
No. How does it taste?
Really good.
Sweet. I call it sweet water to my kids. Hey, you want some sweet water? Yeah, because it tastes sweet. Tastes good. It's pure water.
It makes you drink more.
It makes you drink more. It does. And it's easy to drink because it goes right down so easy. Mm. Okay, so again, beginning protocols are, if you wanted to do more detox, then you want to try to do this, if you can, 3 times a week. Start it out. See what happens. We're going to show you the protocols and different types of ways to be able to do beginning guashing series. And we have probably about 60 videos on Earthshift to show you the more intermediate and advanced, but this is going to be a beginning series. And like I said, these are my tools that we're going to work on Stanley with. And when he walks out of here, he's going to have some bruises on him, most likely, little ones. We call that ecchymosis. And this just means that we opened up that area that wasn't getting blood supply. And you can see the blood in there. And there's a lot of things that live under the tissues. Okay, so we'll pull out a lot of stuff that comes out of his skin. And we've been in here now, perfect timing, because we've been river sweating for, well, he's been here 5 minutes and he was river sweating. So you want to try to river sweat if you can about 30 minutes before you even do any of these protocols we're going to show you, because you want your body to be soft. Remember, you can do the dry steam heat. You can go out in the sun and lay out in the sun and do the protocols that way. Okay, you can soften yourself through the sun. You can make a big fire, take your clothes off and sort of slow roast like a chicken. Okay, and soften yourself up with the heat of the fire, far infrared. You can do all different ways. So, but the easiest way, of course, is just to have a far infrared sauna. You turn it on, and 30 minutes later, it's ready to go. And if you can stand 30 minutes in here when you start river sweating, not the time that when you came in, because it may took you 10, 15 minutes to start river sweating. If you can do 30 minutes of this, this is like doing a 3-day water fast. You ever done a water fast before?
Mm-mm.
Okay, and especially guys that are working, okay? You're working out in the sun and such all day long. You do need certain types of food and energy. So water fasting is made not to really, you know, try it to see if you can do the same work and think the same and everything. No, it's time to rest, okay? You're giving your stomach and your body a rest of food, and you're drinking a ton of water to dry out all the different creatures, the parasites that live in your body. And you stop your body from processing a bunch of food that takes, remember, 80% of your energy field is to process food. So what happens, do you think, if you don't eat food? 80% of that energy goes towards maybe regeneration. So what you do is you rest and do some of the protocols like we do up here at the 21-day retreat. So like I said, all these products, you can do the sauna by themselves, but all these products are very helpful for you to be able to really dig into the pore deep and make it so the one sauna that we're doing right now is like going to be the same with these protocols. It's going to be like him doing it maybe 10 or 15 times. And like I said, the biggest problem is making sure you got enough air, making sure you got enough water, okay, and making sure that you know, you're trying to relax when you're in the sauna too, okay? Open the door up, let some air in. Those are the simplest things that make people say, I don't want to do the sauna because it makes me feel like I'm going to faint. So, you know, experiment with it, play with it. And like I said, the sauna is the best thing that you'll ever do. So you've never been in the sauna. You're impressed about how much you sweat just sitting here? You're not exercising. You know what?
It's a lot.
We played football last night and soccer back and forth. And I sweat pretty good because we used our physical body to sweat. So it's really hard to sweat like this. Okay, he sweats when he works like this because it's out in the hot Hawaiian sun. And these guys are covered up. They're not out there trying to get a tan. They're covered up. Got mosquitoes, bugs, plants are, some of them are sharp, or fire ants sometimes. So you got to be equipped out there. And the biggest reason is because you want to also shield yourself from the sun, because they're in it all day. You're going to go lay up without your clothes maybe for 20 minutes or 30 minutes. So that's different. Okay, here we go. Part two. Whew. Let's see. He's from El Salvador too, right? Your whole family?
Yeah.
Okay, so he's just learning the chaka there. He's got it down good though. All right, here we go.
Okay, we're going to show you what looks like normally after you get done with the... This is a basic washing session, but remember, we did more advanced because his body sweats. You can see how skin's really smooth. He's got little bumps where we work the skin right there. And that's going to all go away in a couple days. See, raise your arm up there. You can see little marks there. We didn't do too much. There's not too much damage, but if you dig deeper in here, all that part will really bruise up. And let's turn around on your back. And his back I did pretty hard there, because on everybody, his skin was really healthy, so, and it was sweating like crazy, but this is just normal. Okay, so, perfect. Let me see your neck. This side. Yeah, we forgot that side. Yeah, because that one side's red and the other side isn't, so. Okay, does it hurt at all?
No,
can't feel a thing. Just no. Like I said, it looks like you got beat up a little bit.
Yeah, it looks like somebody beat me.
Yeah, hit you with a rope. With latigo.
Yeah, with the wimp.
All right.
No, everything is fine. It doesn't hurt that much, so it looks like, but it's not.
Okay, he's going in the waterfall right now, and it's a beautiful sunny day in Hawaii. Woohoo!
Okay. There we go. Aloha.
Important reminder, all information and ideas are for informational purposes only and are in no way intended as medical advice or as a substitute for medical counseling. Earthshift Products, Dr. Robert Cassar, all of their partners, affiliates, and subsidiaries will not be held accountable for the use or misuse of the information presented therein. This information is not intended as medical advice. The authors, publishers, and speakers of this work are not medical doctors and do not recommend the use of mineral-deficient foods, drugs, or medicines to achieve beauty and to alleviate health challenges. Because there is always some risk involved, all persons involved with the development and distribution of this information are not responsible for any adverse effects or consequences of any kind resulting from the use or misuse of any suggestions or procedures described on our website or Earthshift Live radio talk show or therein.